Star science YouTuber Sabine Hossenfelder has had a come-to-Jesus moment about climate change. She doesn't quite get there. She got a surprise when she realised that the climate models that predict the Earth's temperature, and that it's going to be a catastrophe, actually have huge errors calculating the actual absolute temperatures of the Earth. So they only ever plot differences in temperature as the carbon dioxide levels increase.
There's a little secret hidden in this figure. Raise your hand if you've seen it before. This figure, then, shows the simulations for the temperature in the past from different models. Each of these squiggly lines here is a different climate model, the rainbow of scientific uncertainty, so to speak. The fat red line is the mean value of the models, and the fat black line is the data. If you want to look for your favorite color, here's the list of models. The relevant bit that I want to draw your attention to is the vertical axis. As you've probably noticed, climate scientists usually don't tell you the actual temperature. They tell you a temperature anomaly. That's the deviation from a baseline. So why do they do this in the first place? Why not just use the absolute temperature? Very good question. Thanks for asking. The issue is that they predict wildly different temperatures, and most of them are way off the observations. This is hidden in this figure on the right side here. See that it has an absolute temperature scale? And these thin lines here, those are the absolute temperatures for the different models. As you can see, they differ by as much as 3 degrees. That's more than the total warming over this entire period.
Now, that is something that almost nobody knows. We've been told that models are rock solid and that they can't even get the Earth's average temperature without all the extra carbon dioxide.
But that the models disagree so much about the absolute temperature tells you that there's something not quite right about the physical basis of these models. And I don't like that at all.
And neither do I. And she's right. There are many of the physical processes which we just don't understand properly, such as the way clouds convert water vapour into rain. There are huge gaps in our knowledge about why some clouds rain, some don't, and how much water vapour will be left in the cloud after it rains. These are hugely important because water vapour is by far the most important greenhouse gas. So if a model is not calculating these things correctly, it can get all the wrong numbers about water vapour, or require some other compensating error to fix the original errors, and two wrongs don't make a right, which is certainly happening to some extent in some of these models. Also, clouds are crucial in reflecting incoming solar radiation and also absorbing outgoing infrared radiation, especially in the infrared spectral windows. I could go on, but unlike a lot of the physics that Sabina works on, which is based on the laws and quantum physics and relativity or whatever, and those laws are very precisely known, there are huge holes in our knowledge about fundamental science about how the Earth's weather system works.
Tells you that there's something not quite right about the physical basis of these models.
But Sabina is still in a state of denial.
None of what I just told you is news to climate scientists. They know this full well. At least I hope they do. But I don't like it that they don't mention it. The reason this bothers me is that downplaying the shortcoming of the models leads people to underestimate the risk of delaying the energy transition. Because just look at all those net zero plans that countries are making. They all rely on this mean estimate. But it might be that the reality is far worse.
Actually, that is a technically reasonable conclusion if we don't look at all the other evidence about climate. Like the fact that the Holocene climatic optimum a few thousand years ago was considerably warmer than today, even though the carbon dioxide levels were quite low. Or the fact that there's massive negative feedback mechanisms that operate to stabilise the climate. The actual conclusion I think she needs to contemplate is that climate science is corrupted as many other fields of science, such as her own, theoretical physics. And Sabina knows that how bad that was, as she explained in a remarkable video on how she went from being a brilliant physicist to being a brilliant YouTuber. She realised that science is corrupted by having to get research money and by groupthink.
A lot of water has flown under the bridge since, so let me be honest. At this point, I'd figured out what you need to put into a grant proposal to get the money, and that's what I did. I applied for grants on research projects because it was a way to make money, not because I thought it would leave an impact in the history of science. I did what I said I'd do in the proposal. I did the calculation. I wrote the papers. I wrote my reports, and the reports were approved. Normal academic procedure. But I knew it was bullshit, just as most of the work in that area is currently bullshit, and just as most of academic research that your taxes pay for is almost certainly bullshit.
So, Sabina, why do you think that climate science is any different from particle physics? Same forms of corruption, money, groupthink. I was actually in the same place as Sabina 20 years ago. In my own little speciality of the Great Barrier Reef, we'd proven that mud and sediment from farming was not killing the Great Barrier Reef. We'd invented the instruments for measuring this and we'd got all the data. But the science institutions kept maintaining a fiction, and they still do. And although I knew there was corruption in my little area, I thought the other areas of science, like climate science, must be rock solid, like Sabina. But the same lack of quality assurance, the same necessity to maintain funding is the same in most areas of science, and climate science has the added problem that there is ideology involved. To disagree on a matter of theoretical physics does not make you an evil person. Like if you claim that the Great Barrier Reef is fine because it's got record amounts of coral, or if you suggest that we only face a climate inconvenience rather than a climate catastrophe. I finally realised that there is a problem in science as big as science itself. Sabina, I think, is only halfway on her journey. You see, it's bad enough to contemplate there's a climate catastrophe, but it's also, for a scientist, horrible to realise the depth of corruption across the field. And you don't want to acknowledge the truth.
That's impossible!
Search your feelings, you know it to be true.
No! No!
That's how I felt. Sabina may well feel the same.